Hi, welcome to Aruba. This is Margaret Byrd, and welcome to Color Quest. Today, I'm going to be looking at something that I foraged from a beach on the eastern side of the island, which is quite rugged. You cannot swim in the sea there. It's really a wild sea. And I started finding these small, round, what looked like seeds all over the beach that we were at. And I decided to collect them because they were in abundance. And I believe what they are is coconut seeds. The beach that we were at, it was in Aruba National Park, which part of that park has an old plantation that was a coconut plantation centuries ago. And whether or not these are coconut seeds from then, I doubt. But obviously, these are things that have been washed up on the very wild sea. So I've collected them. I'm going to go ahead and put them in a bucket and let them soak for maybe a day or at least part of a day and see if I can sort of loosen up the shells and try. I'm guessing I might get a brownish color or a tan color, beige maybe, but I thought it would be kind of fun since definitely coconuts, although were probably brought here as a plantation crop, but they are still prevalent on the island of Aruba today. So let's see what I can make with what I believe are coconut seeds. I wanted to show you some of the coconut seeds that I found earlier at a different beach, but it felt like the right thing to take you back to the beach so you could see just how beautiful it is here and how much amazing stuff there is actually if you look around to forage. So these are the nuts that I found on the beach, and there were just hundreds of them. So I collected a handful and I'm curious to see if they will make some dye. I'm gonna guess they're gonna make some kind of a tannic looking dye, meaning in the brown family. So first I'm gonna do is, since they are hard, I'm gonna go ahead and soak them and see if that might help release this outer shell. I don't know, there's like a white coating on the outside. You can kind of see it with this one here. They're super pretty. Ooh, and there's a little seaweed. I picked them up. They were all tangled up in seaweed that had washed up on the shore. So I'm going to dump them into a bucket here and go ahead and cover them with water and let them soak. If I were at home, I probably would give them a little bit more time to soak, but only in the last few days I have here, I might only soak them for part of a day. Maybe overnight. So you can see that these seeds float. Actually, so in order to help try to get them submerged in the water to help maybe break down a little bit of that outer coating, I filled the bucket more than I normally would so that I could press this down and get them totally submerged so they will be underwater at least for a few hours. Alright, so I let the coconut seeds soak overnight in a bucket of water, and now we're gonna get the fun job of trying to smash them open. Breaking up the pieces into smaller pieces can often help release, if there's color, release that color more easily in the dye pot. So let's see if we can smash open these coconut seeds. Got myself a rock from the garden, because I figured that was good as anything. And let's check it out. They feel a little bit softer. Let's go ahead and see what happens when we smash it. Well, that one was hard. Let's try a different one. There we go. Got a little bit more out of that. And you can see there's even some color that came with that one. Let's flip it over, see if we can. There we go. Breaking it up. Definitely, this one almost looks like a little coconut. All right, I'm gonna keep smashing away. Well, this one, awesome. Look at that. Seriously, it's a sweet, tiny little coconut. Took a couple more bangs to open it up, but I got it. So I was able to smash maybe half of them, but some of these are just too hard, but I was able to peel away some of that outer coating like that, which would be part of the place where I think that the color is going to come from. And you can see that some of these are truly like little tiny coconuts. So I'm going to go ahead and work with this, pour in some water and let them simmer on the stove for, we'll check it out in about an hour. I want to mention is that this, I have no clue what's going to turn out here for this coconut seeds that I foraged on the beach, but this is one of those elements of natural dyeing that is about exploration and experimentation and just trying things out. I have not looked up a recipe for it, and I'm just gonna wing it and see what happens. I know that when I worked with black walnut, which is a known dye that has a really strong tannin content, that it makes this incredibly deep, dark brown dye. I'm just kinda go with my sort of feelings of, well, this is also a nut of sorts, and it has a fibrous outer coating, so maybe there's gonna be dye there. So remember, always, always come into it with curiosity and testing out just different things you might have to see what actually happens. Now, let's go put the coconuts on the stovetop and see if we can get some dye out of it. So we'll look at that in a bit, but let's go put some water on these coconut nuts and get to brewing. And there's a lot of little bugs here.